Danny Simcox, Park Ranger with Story County Conservation here. Just wanted to show all our fans and park users a little bit about one of my favorite activities to do in Story County, which is fishing the Skunk River for smallmouth bass. There's a lot of ways to do it, and I'll be the first to admit that I think bar none the best way is with the use of a vessel of some kind, so a canoe or kayak. Generally, the Skunk River north of Ames is not conducive to motorized boats, so canoes and kayaks would be your best bet. And there's actually a designated water trail from Story City to just south of Ames, where we have several access points that make it easy to get on and off the water. There's signage at each access that explains a little bit about the history and fish species that you could expect to catch or encounter in the river system, and then also mileage to the next access, which is especially valuable if you're planning a canoe trip. So what we're doing today is actually we're wading the river, and this is what I keep with me. A pair of pliers and a little plastic sack filled with some goodies for the fish. So my preference is a 16th ounce jig with a 2 to 3 inch, some people call them curly tail grubs. I know them as twister tails. There's other things you can use, but these pack super easy. I've got several hours of fishing right here, and again, it keeps me light, and it's a known producer, so you know that's what I've got rigged up right now, a 16th ounce white jig head with a 3 inch white twister tail. You don't really need much else, so we can kind of walk up river here, and right now the river is pretty clear, so you can see where you're walking. Look for those holes for current breaks next to rocks or log jams, that they're a predatory fish, so a lot of times they're gonna sit off in the light current and wait for their prey to come by in the faster current where they can kind of attack them. So we're gonna try and put our jig right in front of their face just by walking upstream and casting into what we think are the deep spots. My preference, if I'm wading the river, is to just wear some shorts and some old shoes. A lot of people use waders, but I find them to be restrictive. And then you always run into the instance where you might walk into a little bit deeper hole than you anticipated, and they can fill up on you. So this is a pretty good situation right here, where we've got some kind of aerated water coming through the downed tree there. And if we look at the deep cut bank on the opposite side, look at the bubbles on top of the water, how they're swirling right in that deep part. That's one of the situations on the river that we're looking for, where you could normally expect to find some fish. The smallmouth sitting in the current break or just behind it in the kind of slow swirling deep water, waiting to ambush the bait fish or crawdads that come by. Longer casts are definitely the preference. So in my opinion, 2011 and 2012 were fairly significant drought years that had a pretty
pretty negative impact on the fishery. Again, that's my opinion. I can't cite any scientific literature. I just know the kind of fish I was catching before that and the kind of fish I've been catching after. That being said, you know, we're 8-9 years removed from that, and I think for the most part, the fishery's gotten better every year. And part of that is people recognizing that it took a hit, and you know, a lot of us still continued to enjoy it when the fishing wasn't quite as active as we had gotten used to, and some of the bigger fish weren't quite as big as we had gotten used to, but we were still coming out here and having fun. And I felt like at that time, you know, it was important to catch and release, especially some of the bigger fish that we know are laying eggs every year and producing young. But since the droughts of 11 and 12, we're still catching a pretty decent quantity of fish, but the average definitely wasn't quite as big. But here this last year, it was actually about this time of year, I took my wife and my daughter out. My wife loves to canoe the river. My daughter was just 2 at the time, and she hadn't been out yet. So we wanted to get in a short paddle and see how she did. Of course, I brought my fishing gear along because I'm not going to the river without fishing, and that's just that. So we ended up, you know, just being in the right place at the right time. We floated over a pretty deep hole that had a lot of big female fish in it, and we each caught a couple smallmouth in the 16 to 18 inch range, which I hadn't seen in quite some time. So I think we're getting back to that point where it's really a quality fishery again. I've had days where I've put in long paddles, you know, both last summer and the summer before that, where I've caught over 100 fish. You know, that's a good 6 hours or so of fishing and floating. But the action can be really fast if you hit it at the right time, and if you just kind of take your time and fish out the spots where you end up getting into a few.
I think any time when you're accessing the fishery on foot, you need to be as quiet as possible.
So when I first got up on this little dry spot right here, I saw 3 or 4 smallmouth jet off into that deep dark water. And I'm sure they're probably 200 yards upstream by now.
Feel free to do what you gotta do. I'm not leaving until I get
this. Oh, good little turtle. Little turtle. Oh, I think it's a little snapper. Yeah.
How did you spot that?
The old baby snapper.
These are really good. Take 1 foot of step at a time. I got these big long giraffe legs.
A tooth!
There you go.
A tooth. Cool.